As expected, last week's Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas was all about tablets. Rival devices to Apple's iPad will be coming out throughout 2011, and with CES over, the shape of the market is looking a little clearer. Some of the biggest buzz at the show was for Honeycomb, version 3 of Google's Android operating system and the first developed for tablet PCs rather than smartphones. Motorola's Zoom, which will use the software, was unveiled at CES and is due to be launched in the next few months.
Up till now, these tablets have basically been big smartphones. And for the first time this spring, we'll start to see tablets like the Motorola Zoom that run on a version of Android that is really much better suited for that screen size.
At least two other vendors, Toshiba and Asus, also demoed Honeycomb tablets, and more are on the way, but it won't be the only technology taking on the iPad. Research in Motion, which makes the BlackBerry smartphone, has its playbook that runs on a proprietary platform, and Hewlett-Packard has promised a tablet based on the webOS software it purchased from Palm.
We see this becoming a three-horse race pretty quickly. We see iPad leading, and then Motorola and BlackBerry Research in Motion's tablet duking it out for second and third place. HP, who is not showing at CES, is kind of a wild card here.
The first iPad competitors are due to hit shelves in the next few months, by which time many expect Apple will have announced an update for its tablet.
By the end of the March, we will see probably the iPad 2, as well as then we'll have the release of the Motorola tablet based on Honeycomb, the Zoom. We will also see the release at that point of Playbook. So at that point in time, I think it is a good time to buy, because there'll be a lot of choices from a lot of different vendors. Later in the year, I think we're going to see lower prices, to be honest. So if you want to wait to let these guys battle it out and keep undercutting each other on price, maybe.
Missing from much CES tablet talk is Microsoft. Bill Gates brought tablets to Las Vegas during his 2001 Comdex keynote and pushed them for several years, but had little success. When Apple announced the iPad, Microsoft was caught napping without a tablet-optimized OS. Windows 7-based tablets were on show at CES, but that operating system isn't designed for tablet PCs.
Windows offers a very rich computing experience, but on a touch-first tablet, consumers are expecting something different. So it might not meet consumers' expectations at this early point.
For greater success, Microsoft might have to wait until the next version of Windows. At CES, it said it would produce a version for ARM chips, the processors around which many tablets are based.
Microsoft announcing they're going to be porting Windows to ARM architectures, that's a big deal. However, let's be honest, it's probably 2 years away. So let's not hold off, let's not wait for that one. And by then, the world's going to be very different.
While the post-CES dust settles, one thing is already clear. 2011 is going to bring a lot of competition for the iPad, and that is good for consumers. Martin Williams, IDG News Service.